that way I could defend my own life. But then I, another luck, I don't know what is luck, I become a servant for my uncle who was an ambassador in England, in Harley Street, in So I was a cleaner and a cooker, and I would bring the children from this and that. And well, I had a dream. I had a dream I can't explain, and I cannot, I don't know how to say it, but I had a vision and a dream that I have to do something with my life. And I'm going to, and no one would help me to get it. Because no matter where I went, I was a girl, and I was useless, and I was uneducated, and just whatever. I did it. I become a model. How I did it, I don't know. I made it to the top, but I haven't forgotten one thing. That promise I did when I was lying in that road in the desert, that I could not sleep another night, no matter what success, no matter what money. I'm sorry I'm talking a little longer, maybe. Huh? I'm sorry, huh? But let me get that story. So, I did it, and I can sit here today to you after 26 years of fighting this female genital mutilation, a horrible crime against a woman, and no one really cared for it, and nobody wanted to do anything about it. Now I can sit here in great success say today, the day I started this was 70 to 90% of FGM, that how high it was. Today, I can sit here and say it's 7%. Lord, come on now.
Thank you. Come on. Thank you.